In the real world, a man may simply be a dustman, collecting dustbins from day to day, whereas in the virtual world, he may be Falcor, the holy warrior, crusading for justice and glory. Some people may prefer to take the virtual route than live in the real world, and may neglect the real world altogether, seeing as in the false world, they could actually have a position of high esteem and power, maybe lead their own guilds, lead entire raiding parties into deep, dark dungeons, killing demons as they go. That's got to be preferable than just collecting dustbins.
You're no doubt wondering, hey, Shatner, how do I hurl bolts of lightning? Simple. Get World of Warcraft, dog. You can be anyone you want. I'm William Shatner, and I'm a shaman.
I can be Super Mortal Phil, defender of my countrymen, and a super stud who gets to have cool hair while playing. And in this virtual world, I'm agile, powerful, and I never have to do what my wife said.
Well, that may look like fun and games, but the problem is people are spending 10 to 12 hours a day addicted to living in virtual fantasy worlds just like that, instead of paying attention to their real lives. Even young children are becoming addicted to video games. Nintendo, Xbox, you name it, they are playing it instead of spending time on the playground. This is creating virtual chaos in homes all across America, and that's what I'm going to deal with today, starting right now. Today on an all-new Dr. Phil. Is someone you love obsessed with video gaming?
My eyes were burning, my wrists ached.
These games are supposed to be fun, not wreck lives and ruin marriages. He's spending as much as 80 hours a week.
He gets up at noon and he stays on it till 12, 1, 2 in the morning.
Your family is gonna lose their house if you don't get off your computer. How to control the obsession before it's too late.
In the outside world, I am a simple geologist. But in here, I am Falcorn, defender of the Alliance. I've braved the Fargo Deep Mine, defeated the Bloodfish at Jared's Landing.
Oh. Looks like that guy just killed you.
I wanted to quit straight away. I mean, as soon as I started playing, I knew that this was bad. I knew that after maybe a month, I knew that this would interfere with my schoolwork. So I wanted to quit already then, but I ended up playing the game for 3 years.
3,000 hours. 3,000 hours clicking on that mouse, collecting weapons and gold. It's almost as if it was a huge waste of time.
Whoever did this knew what they were doing. He got in and out of your account in under 15 minutes, transferred all your stuff, and didn't leave a digital fingerprint.
Oh! There isn't enough chamomile tea in the world to quell the rage in my heart.
Hey.
Hey, Penny, we're kind of in the middle of a crisis here.
Oh, I know. Bernadette told me. Sorry, Sheldon. I know that game meant a lot to you.
That game? Excuse me, Penny, but Doodle Jump is a game. Angry Birds is a game. World of Warcraft is a massively multiplayer online role-playing. Right, technically it's a game.
All right, see you later.
Oh, hello.
Oh, hi. I was just dropping off a cheesecake to Sheldon. He was robbed of a bunch of imaginary crap that's useful in a make-believe place.
I don't know what that means.
Yeah, well, sadly, I do.
These games are supposed to be fun, not wreck lives and ruin marriages, but that's what happens when people get addicted. Not just hobby, I'm talking about addicted to playing online computer games. Now, many of these addicts, perhaps including one of my guests today, is an adult. Can you imagine the power these games could wield over your children? This addiction has become a huge problem for my guests, Julie and Fred. Now, Julie claims Fred's day consists of getting up at noon, playing on the computer all day, and virtually ignoring his entire family.
My husband plays video games from morning
awful night. It's affecting all the relationships in the house. My kids are out of control, and we can't pay our bills. It's just a lot of things that all circulate from the game.
Fred loved his graphic design job, and he made really good money.
He hasn't worked in 9 months. He says it's because he can't find another job, but he's not even really looking for another job. He's just fiddling away on the computer.
I think he is addicted to the games because if the game wasn't there, I think he would get up and go get a job.
World of Warcraft takes my mind off other things.
There's actually been times where he's never gone to bed because he's played throughout the whole night.
No, sometimes you don't realize because you get so involved with something that time just kind of flies by.
We've spent New Year's Eve with him on the game, Christmases with birthdays, with one anniversary. He gave me his credit card to go shopping. He played his game and I went to the mall. There's very minimal interaction. I've always felt like I'm alone in this marriage. I feel like we're just coexisting in the same house. We don't even sleep up here together. He sleeps downstairs by the computer every night.
I'm trying to deal with the game and the relationship. The game's kind of winning, though. I like to not play as much. I still want to play the game. Well, my fears are that, I'm going to probably lose my wife eventually if I stay on it, for sure. If I lose my wife, she'll want to take the kids, but I don't want to lose my kids. So, it's a fear.
I think if this whole situation doesn't change, it could lead to a divorce.
Well, according to Julie, Fred left his successful career due to his excessive game playing. Now, unfortunately, Julie is now solely responsible for financially supporting this family of five.
We are beyond our means now. No matter how much I work and make, there's just no catching up.
We're kind of in a pinch as it is, so... I don't spend anything playing this game.
I am getting really scared. Our electric, $277, we just paid $500 on it, and we still owe $277. This is our gas bill for $1,200. And then our mortgage, it was $1,800 a month, but now it's $2,400 a month because we were past due. These are for some checks that bounced because we didn't have enough money in the bank to cover them. I'm very afraid we might lose our house.
Well, with their five-year-old playing next to Fred and the three-year-old running around unattended, the housework just piles up.
When I'm not here, Fred plays his game. Their five-year-old, Justin, plays his game. And Sean, the three-year-old, runs around the house. Sometimes my house is trashed. There's dishes piled, toys everywhere, food on the floor. I could leave these dishes sitting here for days and they would sit there.
I will vacuum. I'll do whatever, I need to do. Take out the garbage or whatever.
My clothes would sit there forever if I didn't put them away. We would just live out of folded clothes on the floor. This room was so messy the other day, you couldn't even see the floor.
I don't do like a ton because she'll do whatever I did over.
If he does clean a room, it's this room. He says he doesn't mess up the kids' rooms and the bathrooms, and so he doesn't clean the rooms that he doesn't feel he messes up. We can't keep up with the house, but as long as he can play his game, all is well in the world.
Okay, you guys have been watching these video pieces, which are you basically talking about your lives. Are you addicted to these virtual world games?
Yes, I am. I'm on the game a lot.
How much is a lot?
Easily 6 to 10 hours a day.
Yeah, because you say that he's spending like as much as 80 hours a week.
You figure he gets up at noon and he stays on it till 12, 1, 2 in the morning. Maybe getting off for an hour in between.
Okay, so my boyfriend just left to go to the store because he has to get smokes. And he thinks he's going to be raiding all night. But let's see about that. All he does is sit on this stupid computer and play this stupid game. And I'm getting sick of it. I'm gonna delete all his things. This one was his favorite.
Okay, now. Let's see what his reaction is when he gets back.
And you think that, I'm going to do this a little bit, and I'm going to play a little bit, and it's not going to do anything. I mean, it's just a little, like, 1 hour a day, just when I have free time. But then you seem to notice that you have a lot more free time than you thought, and that free time is taken out of your study time, out of your, I don't know, socializing time, and you just become, like, what happens is you just get away from the world.
So, I mean, you're an intelligent guy, and you had a career before, right?
Yes,
what did you do?
Graphic arts.
So you're skilled. You have a career. You can go out and do things. How do you feel about the fact that you're not working and your wife is working? You say it's not costing you anything to play this game. It's costing you your paycheck. It's costing you your career.
Yeah, you know, when I play the game, I never really thought of it in that way because I'm, like, focused into the game, so.
I would classify game addiction as something when it starts to interfere with your life. Or your daily routine. Say you're supposed to go somewhere, but then you decide, oh, actually, no, I think I'll stay on here for a few more hours. Then, obviously addicted.
There have been occasions when I've been playing, you know, late at night and suddenly realise the sun is shining through the curtains, but that doesn't usually happen anymore.
Julie says her husband, Fred, sits at the computer playing up to 13 hours a day, and it's causing a major breakdown in their marriage. That'll happen when you're unplugged. Julie says Fred completely neglects their 3-year-old while she's at work, and even worse, he's keeping their 5-year-old son, Justin, up late gaming just like dear old dad.
I don't think he spends as much time with the kids as he should spend with them.
I spend more time with the kids than she actually does, and they're with me all the time.
He ignores Sean more than he does Justin.
I think that Sean, when I'm not here, does feel neglected.
I feel Sean needs attention from his dad.
Justin plays World of Warcraft right next to me.
You see how he just turns it on all his own? He has his own password, he does.
What we do is I log onto my character, he logs onto his. We go as a group, and I'll run around with him, helping him.
It actually teaches him things, how to type. I mean, he knows how to type some words already on his own.
I see a lot of similarities between Fred and Justin. Justin throws fits and swears just like Fred.
Your ass.
They act like this a lot. They throw temper tantrums and throw things. My fear is that the kids are not going to have a good relationship with their dad because he does have a little bit of a temper. I think that being that they're boys, they're going to pick up from that, and that's how they're going to be when they're older.
You have to keep playing to keep your form up. And when you stop playing, obviously, you don't lose your skill, but you become rusty, you know, because you haven't played for a while. So I feel that I should keep playing to just keep the performance up, to keep the skill, the reactions, all that kind of stuff. We have a set number of hours we need to play. Sometimes I felt like I needed to play longer to stay better, to stay good, and to, you know, to keep up with my teammates, to keep up with the other other players in the UK and around Europe.
What do you do in this virtual game?
Nobody's gonna know what it is, but we take down raid bosses, and you're always just going for something better. Like in real life, you know, you're always going for something better.
No. It's like in most people's real life.
Well, yeah, in real life, I mean, you want a job, you want a better job. You get a house, you want a better house. And it's almost the same thing in that.
Then you should do that with...
But you don't do that anymore. You do it on the computer, right?
Right, yeah.
Okay, and when you're at level 70 or something?
Yeah, that's as high as you can go right now.
And when you've achieved 70, what is it you've accomplished?
When you hit 70, there's even more to it. You know, there's more areas you go to. Better gear, better weapons, better mounts.
Weapons, better what?
Better mounts, ride, you know, things you ride on the game.
Oh, okay. Now, you talk about these like they're real, like you've got better gear. Have you got any of it with you?
No.
Could you show me some of the better gear?
No, I couldn't.
Have you got your mount tied up outside?
No, I don't.
Because basically, this is just pictures.
Right.
How old are you?
34.
The addictive aspects of gaming, there's a lot of them. I mean, there's the multiplayer aspect. You get, for example, you get 40 people at a time in a certain raid dungeon in World of Warcraft. That does tend to bring you back. I mean, there's a whole social aspect to it. Then there's the fact that it can become a second life in some situations for some people.
When they play the game and become the best, they feel that they're actually of significance, that they're actually an important person. And I guess some people might feel that they might not be important in their life. So when they play, they're in their own world, they're in control. They are that person, you know, they are in control of the game.
World of Warcraft is endless. I mean, the only way you can end it is by stopping playing. Blizzard know this, and they know that World of Warcraft is a cash cow. They know it'll keep bringing them money. And they're introducing new expansions, new levels, new items, blah, 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 so you can further develop your character to however you want it to be. And that's why it's so addictive, because there is no end to the game. There's no, like, last level which you finish and that's it. It just goes on until you stop. And some people can't stop, and that's why it's addictive.
There's the competitive atmosphere as well. That definitely kind of keeps people coming back for more. The whole, maybe if I play one more round, I might finally be able to beat that guy who's been kicking my ass all this time sort of feeling. There's the... also, most games encourage that by having a leaderboard at the end so you can see where you've come in relation to everybody else. So you feel that one more try, I might be able to come at the top of that leaderboard or maybe get above the person who's above me.
I personally knew someone, actually, who would make up excuses, any excuse, for whenever we used to ring him to come out with us or go out somewhere or anything. He used to make up any excuse, like, say, oh, you had to stay at home for a reason. And when I knew full well that he'd just be there playing games.
Any normal gamer can, in some circumstances, become too involved with the game and find themselves playing for far longer than they should, so it should always be important to keep moderation in mind when playing.
You meet a lot of new people, and you like that. And it sort of creates two worlds, one world where you're in World of Warcraft and one world where you're sort of in real life. And it's cool going between two worlds.
I think I play on average about the same as most other gamers, well, at least most other gamers, the more slightly more hardcore crowd, I guess, but I generally don't play as much as some.
Level 70 undead mage. Put a lot of time into him, and he's almost maxed out on enchanting and tailoring. Cabo Wabo, he's a level 67 hunter. Level 6700, not far from 70. Herbalism, alchemy. Some of the reasons I love playing the game are that you get to interact with other people. Progress that you can see in numbers, going up in levels, increasing skills and abilities. It gives you a sense of satisfaction, like you've accomplished something. And basically you're lost in this other world, the world of Azeroth. And in that world, you can be a champion, you can be a hero.
You're here because she's like fed up with this, right?
But yes. The problem is when, you know, like if I do something wrong, I know I've done it wrong, I acknowledge I've done it wrong, and I'll say, yes, I do that. But when he does something wrong and it's affecting our relationship or our family or our finances, I'm wrong. It's like he never can see what's really going on.
But you don't get a vote. You're not working.
No, I don't.
So you're saying you disagree with this, you disagree with that. But the truth is, you've kind of sacrificed your leadership role in this family, true?
True.
You've become addicted to the computer and you're not taking care of business. You're not taking care of business mentally, emotionally, spiritually, physically. You're just not taking care of business. You're just playing games. Yeah. And I'm telling you that because somebody needs to step up and tell you this. Your family is going to lose their house if you don't get off your computer and go out and get a job. And you know how to do that, it's just to flip her off.
He's very smart. There's so many things he can do and everything
well,
I tell him to do.
Apparently he's got you supporting him and taking care of the kids and the house. Everything. I wonder what level that is in the real world. I mean, there may be 70 in there, but I think you're probably towards the bottom of the stack as far as where you'd put him on real world performance, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, don't start feeling sorry for him.
No, I'm not feeling sorry.
No, you are too, because I'm taking the hide off of him because somebody needs to. And so you start going, oh.
This is Autumn, and she is seriously ready to walk out on her fiancé, Sean, because she has had it. He has been seduced by a new love, but it's not another woman.
The happy home of Autumn, Sean, and their baby daughter was recently interrupted by an intruder.
I'm so tired and fed up with this game, World of Warcraft.
Sean is addicted to World of Warcraft, a very popular video game. He spends every waking moment in front of the screen, leaving Autumn feeling like a single parent.
All right, it's 6:45. Sean's been playing for about an hour and a half now, and I'm just trying to keep Madison occupied, trying to keep her calm. She's been kind of cranky today.
Sean's addiction has gotten so bad, he will even ignore his crying baby girl right behind him.
Tyra, will you please teach me how to show Sean some tough love?
It's interesting, Autumn, because I have heard stories and been in relationships where, you know, I'm being ignored because he's running out with his friends or doing things with human beings. But he's doing this with a video game, something that's just a computer.
Right.
It's not real. Mm-hmm. How does that feel, that he's choosing that over you, a human, beautiful woman, and a child?
It feels like the life that I'm trying to give him, the life of me and Madison, isn't good enough. Like, mm-hmm. It's just not enough for him anymore.
Mm-hmm. Well, give me some examples of when he's choosing the game over you.
I'm gonna have two examples that really stick out. On his birthday in June, we were supposed to go to a birthday dinner, and he kept telling me, five more minutes, and it turned into hours, and we ended up missing his birthday dinner. And also, when I was in labor with our daughter, it took a while, so he went home to take a shower, and he ended up getting on the computer and playing for about 3 hours, and then came back to the hospital before I gave birth.
He left you to go play the game while you were in labor?
Yeah.
That, Dr. Gary.
You know, I think that's pretty intense, right?
That's the biggest thing in the world. Somebody having your woman having a baby and leaving for a video game, that's very intense.
Why would a guy do that? I mean, is it the game? Is it what would that, why would somebody do that? Why would he miss the most important moment of his life? What do you think?
That's where I'm stuck. I don't know if it's me. I don't know if it's the new changes of a daughter and just a new lifestyle. I don't know if it's scaring him or I just don't know what to think.
So it's really a mystery to you.
It is.
All you know is that your fiance is taken away from you by this game.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And how many hours a week does he spend it doing
I'd say it's about a full-time job, about a 40-hour week.
He spends 40 hours a week with the game?
Right.
Does he have a job?
He does. He's off at 3 every day, 3:30 every day. So when he comes home, he generally gets on sometimes an hour after he gets home, but he plays until about 2 in the morning.
So when is there time for you and the relationship?
Hardly ever.
And then what about intimacy? How's intimacy with you guys?
Yeah, how's that work?
Well, generally he sleeps on the couch. Why does he sleep on the couch?
It's closer to the computer. Just kidding. I don't.
Well, that's true, but also he makes excuses. He says our bed's uncomfortable. And when he does come to bed, it's 2 a.m, so I've been asleep for, you know, hours.
Mm-hmm. Have you ever threatened to leave him if this continues?
All the time. I threaten him, and he just kind of brushes it off like it's either no big deal or he doesn't believe me.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I'm carrying everything. There's days that I drive to work and my stomach is literally in knots thinking about how I'm going to pay this bill and how I'm going to pay that bill. And my phone rings off the hook all day long with creditors. All day it rings off the hook. And all he does is play the game.
Now, Julie's 15-year-old son, Brandon, says Fred is just plain lazy. And that's his word, not mine. He says he's fed up with his stepdad sitting in front of the computer, game playing all day while his brothers just run wild, the bills go unpaid, and his mom is forced to financially support the family.
My stepdad, Fred, is very aggressive.
Justin, knock it off.
He's addicted to this game, and he's rude.
Justin, quit doing that.
Brandon's 15, and he knows, you know, everything. You can't tell him what to do. We got along when he was little, but after the two little ones were born, Justin and Sean, I think it's a sense of jealousy.
I think that the game has made him bitter. It's kind of like taking over his life. The reason I think he won't get a job is because he's just lazy. It's really frustrating to watch him just do nothing. While my mom's doing all the cleaning, doing all the working. She struggles a lot, you know, with bills and having to buy food for everybody. One day in the kitchen, my mom and Fred were fighting, and he got angry and he pushed her into a cabinet. I wouldn't say she was hurt, but she was frightened, I could tell. That was scared. I feel like I just want him to change, and if he changes, then maybe it will be better. But if he just continues the way he acts, I think my mom should just not be with him anymore.
So he's protecting his mom?
Yes.
He's feeling like you're being exploited? Taken advantage of, and you are the only one working in a family of five. Your stepson says that if you don't play the game, if you're prevented from it in some way, that you get real agitated.
That's not true.
That is true. He gets over the silliest things. We get into screaming matches, and it always seems to be when he's not playing his game.
Mm-hmm. What the fuck? You stole my fucking leather belt!
I hop on, and once I'm on, I'm not coming off, because it is just, it's too fun, it's too good. I can't, it's my life.
Hey, honey, it's
Mom, Blaise. Just get out of my room!
Blaise,
get the freak out of my room! Oh, can you get out of my room? Leave my room!
Sorry if you guys had to hear me yelling like that, dude. My mom's being such a bitch, dude. She won't leave me the fuck alone, man. Well, pretty much I just wake up in the morning, you know, sit up, get up, and then I just start my day off with WoW. I usually walk over, get on, check who's on Skype, see which friends are online.
What's it called? Mortal Kombat and stuff like that. He used to play those games, but I guess it was later in middle school when he really got, when this whole WoW thing, World of Warcraft, I think it's called.
Mom, I told you to leave me alone. All I want to do is play some freaking WoW. Just get the hell out of my room.
He really has a serious problem, and I know people think, like, how can you be addicted to video games, or, you know, it's not really that big of a deal, but in all honesty and reality, if you live with someone and see their addiction to a video game, it's pretty serious.
I don't understand why she always has to come into my room when I'm trying to just... It's just so... I can't do it.
These are sick cinematic stuff.
4 years have passed since the mortal races banded together and stood united against the might of the Burning Legion.
The basic idea of WoW is, you know, you have Azeroth and Kalimdor. Now, Kalimdor, it's like, there's two different, like, continents. There's Kalimdor, there's Azeroth, and you got the Horde, and you got the Alliance.
Everything on his Christmas list was WoW, WoW, WoW. And then it just got WoW crazy. He's now started to replace his real friends with imaginary WoW friends.
From when I come home at work, which is at like 2 in the morning, 2 a.m., he's in there and I can still hear him playing WoW. And then I wake up at about noon, still hear all the noise and music from the game. So he's pretty much playing it all day long.
On my Warlock, I have over 121 days. And on my Death Knight, I have over 86 days. So, a good, at least over 200 days playing this game.
All he does is eat frozen junk food, which is disgusting.
He makes me bring him Hot Pockets. He makes me actually now go to Sam's and buy them in massive quantities. It's like WoW and Hot Pockets all the time. And then it got to the point where we would normally would go out and do family outings and things like that. All of us would leave the house. Blaise would say he wasn't feeling well.
It's sometimes when she comes in here, I wish I just had a small little rock that I could throw at her face just to just shut her up, because it really pisses me off. I'm trying to just, it just pisses me off. All right, hold on, let me. Hey guys. All right, yeah, I'm ready. Take aggro first. Make sure you're collapsing, because if you don't collapse, then we're all gonna wipe.
Collapse.
Death Star, are you really? Death Star! What are you doing? Death Star! You just made us wipe!
All I really want is my little brother back. I'm tired of seeing him in the room like this. Please, somebody out there, get him help.
Miss it?
My game?
Yeah, when you don't play it, do you miss it?
No, I haven't even missed it yet. Never thought of it. I didn't like run out and want to play it or nothing, no.
Well, you know, I think that would, I don't believe that, by the way. I mean.
I could have ran down to internet cafes or whatever and played it out here. I did not do it.
Yeah, no, I understand that, but I think you're drawn to it.
Let's talk about WoW, man. WoW is a fucking addiction. I'm gonna tell you like this. I've been playing WoW for over a year now. It's about a year and a half, I think. And in case people don't know what WoW stands for, like I said, it's World of Warcraft. There's like over 14 million users on there. Kids, adults, married people, single people, fat people, skinny people, ugly people, good looking people. They all play WoW. WoW is a fucking addiction, and I'm one of the people who plays WoW. I've been playing WoW for close to, I don't know, man, over a year and a half. And why do I still play it? I gave up WoW like I don't know how many times I give it up. Wow, man. It's an addiction, man. It's like everybody says, you're on that shit for about, I'd say like 5 to 10 hours a day. Every day is the same thing. Ventrilo, you wake up, you'd wake up, you'd have some snack, right away, boom, you log on WoW. And fucking, first thing you do is try to get your group going on Ventrilo, open up your vent servers and find different vent servers to get into, and you start playing with your team, you know. And this would be on for 6 to 8 hours a day, 10 hours sometimes straight up, playing PvP, you know, player versus player. That's all you would do. You'd get on vent and you'd run over pugs and shit. And you would do this for months, man. I did it for about a month and 2-3 months, something like that, to get the general, and then my WoW got fucked up. And then I did it again on Alliance, man. I got WoW going again after I quit, and I came back for some fucking reason. And I started playing again. It's an addiction, man. Like, behind all this, it's a fucking addiction. It's fun. It's fun playing with people, talking to people on vent or Skype, whatever. It's fun. But when it starts afflicting your real life, if it starts affecting your real life, then it becomes a problem. People, and this is true because I can vouch for it. I sometimes happy to like bring my food, my actual food, man. I take breaks for food, of course, you know, and I bring it to my desk right here, my fucking desk right over here, and I eat while I'm playing or PvPing or questing. Okay, that's how bad WoW has gotten to me for people who are addicts. Sometimes we stay up till 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the morning playing this game, and we wake up like around. Sometimes it's just like we wake up around 12 and we play straight up from 12 all the way down. So that's like, that's over fucking 12 hours, man. It's a long time playing WoW. And it's an addiction, man. It's hard to beat. But we're trying, you know. I play less than I used to. But it's an addiction, man. You're up there, you know, 8, 10 hours, 12 hours sometimes playing WoW nonstop. Just taking a break to eat some food and take a shower and take shit. Whatever, you know.
Miss Collier. According to your complaint, this young man who used to be your boyfriend.
Yes.
Wasn't that funny? And he used to be your roommate. He owes you money. According to you, he owes you money because you paid the first month's rent for him, his share and the deposit. When he got a job, he left. He left because you told him to leave. You kicked him out. You've been fighting?
A little.
Am I going to get an answer from you, or am I going to go to him?
Okay, when I would go to work and come home, he was on the computer playing WoW, which is World of Warcraft. It's like a computer game. So he would always be on it all the time. Instead of looking for a job, he'd be on it. He was always on the computer, always. He was obsessed with it.
You didn't have a job. She had money.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't have a job. Go ahead. Continue.
Okay, so I'm at a loss of words.
Under what circumstances did you leave Mr. Burkhardt?
She told me to leave.
Tell me about it.
Well, I did play World of Warcraft a lot.
What's the name of this game?
World of Warcraft.
Say it slowly.
World of Warcraft.
World of Warcraft.
World of Warcraft.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
You ever heard of that? World of Warcraft. Go ahead.
We didn't spend a lot of time together. We were pretty much in separate rooms. And I guess she didn't feel like she was getting enough attention. She kicked me out.
What did she say to you?
She told me she wants me to leave.
What you're doing is interfering. It's interfering with your definition of a husband and a father. And you could get a job and bring home a paycheck so you didn't have to pay part on a bill and then sweat before the next one comes in and her and your wife having to feel the pressure of all of that.
Well, he's told me that since we don't make enough money that I should go get another job.
She works 3 days a week, 4 hours a day. That's not really helping all that much. But yeah, I'm not working, so yes, it is a problem.
I work 5 days a week.
But she spends more money. She spends way more money than we ever brought in, ever.
You know, when you watch this at home, you're going to be so
sorry. I know.
Really, you're going to wish you hadn't said that.
I was ready for it when I came
home. No, seriously, you're going to wish you hadn't said it. You said she works 3 days a week, 4 hours a day, and it doesn't help that much. And in the same breath,
she spends it before she even gets in the door.
You don't make any.
I know I don't.
So if she's not helping much, you ain't helping any.
I know, but she, yeah.
Well, you know. You know, you just need to get a job and stop playing the game.
I know.
See the animal in his cage.
looking too closely in the eye. Are you sure what side of the glass you are? See the safety of the life you have missed. Everything where it belongs. Feel the hollowness inside of your heart. And it's all right where it belongs. What if everything around you isn't quite as it seems? What if all the world you think you know is an elaborate dream? Get your reflection. Is that all you want to be? What if you could look right through the cracks? Would you find yourself afraid to see? Thank you.
Video game addiction is leaving a trail of virtual chaos for people that get obsessed with playing in a fantasy world, and as a result, they neglect their real world lives. And this is no joke. Here's the thing. It's not what they do on the internet. Fred plays these games. I think he agrees to excess. What happens is what it crowds out, and it can happen with your kids as well.
Teenager hooked on violent computer games. He's playing them an incredible 16 hours a day. His mother says his personality has changed and that he's become moody and violent, and his addiction is tearing the family apart.
They don't realize how addictive it can be.
It's a world of fantasy and fun. But for 16-year-old Cameron Sandler, this is more than a game. It's an addiction and an illness.
I am addicted to the game, but I'm not fully addicted. Like, I can quit whenever I want. This really kicks ass, doesn't it?
It all started 18 months ago when Cameron discovered World of Warcraft.
Oh, now I'm going to kill you all.
This never-ending computer game is played by millions around the globe.
From America, Germany, China, all of Europe, England.
And you've got friends in all of these places?
Yeah.
And that's what you refer to them as, your friends?
Yeah.
They play simultaneously for hours on end.
Well, when you're ready.
Fighting and killing their enemies.
I don't know why, I just eventually got addicted to it.
Cameron has up to 500 players on his team, known as a guild.
The longest I've ever played it for was 12 hours, and that was, just because the guild wanted me on for that long. Oh, you took my kill.
Why do you talk with an American accent when you're talking to these people?
I don't know. It's probably like you move to a new country or something. You just end up picking it up.
And that's not all he picked up.
For f***'s sake.
There's the tension and the violence.
We get keyboards thrown around the room, or holes punched in the wall, or they'll go outside and smash bottles.
Denise is Cameron's mum.
He started off with this going for an hour, 2 hours, 2 hours turned into four, four turned into six, six turns into 12, and he's now into the snowball effect that he's got to play that game.
Cameron is often up at 4 a.m. to begin playing. Sometimes he goes right through the night. His mum estimates that, on average, he's in front of that screen 16 hours a day.
My choice to play it. My choice to be addicted to it.
Cameron reckons he can stand up and walk away whenever he wants. But try telling that to his mum. Denise believes he's hooked. And just like an alcoholic, a smoker or a drug addict, getting off, beating the habit, is going to be an enormous challenge. Regardless of who's right and wrong in this household, experts are now warning that addiction to technology is becoming the fastest growing illness of the 21st century.
No, his situation isn't rare at all. In fact, he's just the tip of probably a very undisclosed iceberg.
Psychologist Edwina Cowdery and her colleagues are seeing more and more cases every day.
The DSM-4, which is the Diagnostic Statistical Manual, basically it's the psychologist's Bible of all the things that we're meant to know about, doesn't have internet addiction in it. I would suspect the next one does, because of the amount of internet addiction in various forms for various ages that we're starting to see.
Do you regret discovering this game?
Kind of taken a lot of time away from me. I could have made up, you know, going out, exploring some more, meeting new people, but other than that, no, because I've gone and explored inside the game. I've met new people inside the game.
Warcraft has had such an impact on players, there are chat rooms on the internet dedicated to addicts. An assistant professor from Harvard University claims up to 40% of users are hooked. And in China, a gifted 13-year-old student killed himself after playing Warcraft for 36 hours straight. The boy left a suicide note saying he wanted to join the heroes of the game he worshipped.
It's a fantasy world. A bit like a book, but a book ends.
I don't want to live like this anymore.
I really don't.
You're right. Do you think people find it hard to believe the impact?
I think so. I think so. I didn't think that a game would be this addictive to this point and change a personality.
Cameron has left school, and at the moment he isn't studying or working. He knows now is the time to tackle his addiction. It's no longer a game.
How many parents do you think will be watching this story tonight and saying, that's me?
I would say a lot.
This is going to be a problem that we're going to be hearing a lot more about.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes, big time. Damn.
When you're so into a game that it interferes with the normal operations of your life.
I think everyone can get into video games because there's an escapism in it. With video games, it's a goal-oriented reward system. You can feel like you've achieved something with really very minimal effort.
There's almost a sense of purpose when you sit down to a video game like that. Because all these characters, these fake people, put all of their hopes onto you and all of their dreams, and the entire process of saving the world rests on no one but your shoulders. The draw to that is astounding.
Games are meant for entertainment purposes. However, there are those that take it to the next level, so to speak, if you will. It can lead to an addiction, very much so.
People don't take it seriously at all, I don't think. I don't even think they think it exists.
Video game addiction is definitely a real issue that needs to be dealt with. People just need to start understanding that you can only dedicate so much time to something like this without it having definite impacts on the real life that you actually have to continue to live around you.
I think what makes people game addicts is just the fact that they love it so much that they just play to play because they don't want to go back to what reality really is for them.
When people talk about video game addiction, it's usually in a kind of comical sense. They think about it and they laugh. They go, oh, you know, just like losers who didn't have a life in the first place are the only ones who ever get addicted to video games. And that's just not true. I've seen people who've never played a video game like their entire childhood lives get up, get into high school, and find one game. That's all it can take, is one video game to ruin a life. And it's just, it's a different one for different people.
Do I think it's going to rise? Do I think it's a small problem? So I don't even think it's a small problem. I think it's still a big problem. I think it's a huge issue. It's obviously a huge issue. It's just not seen as such. When you're playing something or doing anything for an extended period of time, 16 hours, 8 hours at a time, then that means that's 8 hours you're not spending with your loved ones, or 8 hours you're not spending on your work, or 8 hours you're not spending cleaning the house. So it's obviously going to affect your life. And I think that's a big problem.
We're going to add somebody to our conversation named Brad. Now, he says he was so addicted to game playing that he spent 80 hours a week isolated in his basement in front of a computer screen.
I played compulsively for hours. I would start Friday night binge video gaming. And that would go to like, you know, 2, 3, 4 in the morning. And then Saturday all day, Sunday all day. My eyes were burning, my wrists ache. It was 4:30 in the morning, the night before my wedding. My father knocks on the bedroom door and he says, what are you doing? And I said, I'm almost done. He said, are you crazy? You have to get up at 7 o'clock. I look at the pictures from the wedding and I just think, what a waste. My life went out of control. It's like a mistress. My addiction to gaming nearly ended my marriage. The worst day of my addiction was when I attempted suicide by taking an overdose of prescription sedatives. I was feeling overwhelmed, and I just wanted it all to stop.
So why did you take the pills? Was this a feeling of guilt? I mean, had things slipped away so much you couldn't get back to the real world? What happened?
I had built up a debt of about $24,000 because of my gaming. I had really, I had been lying and deceiving my wife as the extent of my addiction. I had lost a career, lost a part of my education.
What game were you playing?
What game didn't I play? I think I'd probably played 16 or 17 different online role-playing games. I'm also have a lot of experience in World of Warcraft, so I understand what Fred is talking about. I had played World of Warcraft obsessively, probably 70 or 80 hours a week.
Brad's computer gaming took a very heavy toll on his marriage. His wife is so embarrassed that her husband is a recovering game addict that she asked us to protect her privacy, but here's a message from her.
When we first were married, it was just like any newlywed. The more he was into gaming, the less interest he seemed to have in sex. Brad became more and more isolated. He didn't want to go out. And he also kind of isolated me from my friends. The suicide attempt was a big wake-up call. His psychiatrist made him tell me that he was addicted to gaming and pornography and had spent over $23,000. He had five different credit cards that I had no knowledge about. He was spending real money on virtual characters. I didn't trust him. I felt like I had been betrayed.
The worst thing I've seen was definitely seeing kids literally like ruin their physical and possibly mental state because of video games.
I was pretty addicted to video games. There was a point where I was probably playing 10 hours a day for at least a year.
The problem is you never feel like you're losing anything. So they don't notice when their girlfriends stop calling. They don't notice when their family stops inviting them out to dinners. They don't notice when all their friends stop calling them to go out to movies because they know that they only want to play their video games for the rest of the night.
I used to back out of plans, or I'd always think of what I had to do in the video games first before hanging out with actual people. So if I was like, no, I have to do something else in this game, I'd be like, no, I can't go tonight. I have some homework I have to do, or just come up with some lame excuse because people didn't really know I played. It was just a secret.
There's a couple times when I'd try and get him to go to a movie or go do something, but he had something to do in Warcraft. So he wouldn't admit it at first that that's why he wanted to stay home, but I'd end up finding out.
There's no way to lie about it, because eventually everyone's going to find out. You can say you're going and doing other things, but you know, eventually it's going to come around that you ditched out to go and play Warcraft, you ditched out to play Halo, or you... That's really the only thing you can do, is just stop leaving your house. And the people that you do that to frequently eventually stop getting upset about it, and they just stop calling you.
I have seen it wreck lives and ruin relationships, so...
He seriously, like, I asked him what he's going to do in his day, and he's like, well, I'm going to go to work, do my thing, come home, make supper, tuck my kids in bed, do a raid, say goodnight to my wife, do another raid, and fall asleep. I was like, you seriously put World of Warcraft in your daily schedule? And he was like, yeah, totally. And you know that once he does retire, he's gone.
I had raids I had to run. I had instances. I had gear that I needed to get. More importantly than finding a girlfriend or hanging out with my friends or finding a new job or getting to school, Warcraft always comes first.
Massive multiplayer online game, is that it? MMORPG, I guess. And it's a game where you can go into a little fake world, actually a big fake world, and be a character and interact with other characters who are real people through the internet. So you can have anywhere from 6,000 people at a time playing to 100,000, 200,000 people at a time playing.
MMOs is probably the biggest deal to it. You have people who pay a monthly fee in order to continue to play a video game with consistent updates. The games are designed to suck people in. You have like registered event times. Certain things will happen on certain days at certain times in exactly the same place. So people will start scheduling their lives around in-game events.
So I ended up having to actually go on a friend's account and go into the game as like a little dwarf, or I don't know, it was an elf or something, and go in and find them. And actually, like, ask him, would you like to go for a beer? Elven Druid number 6 or whatever his name is, and it, he wouldn't. He had to go kill a dragon or something.
You wouldn't have taken my computer away.
I think it's so addictive because you get that interaction between people, and the game is always, always changing. There is no end. You just keep playing.
Even kids as young as 8 years old are now spending 13 hours a week playing these games, so it's a very real concern. Now, my next guest knows this all too well. On Thanksgiving Day 2001, Liz Woolley found her 21-year-old son, Sean, dead in front of his computer while an online fantasy game was still on the screen.
Hooked on video games. We're talking about young people who play for hours, even days at a time.
EverQuest is so addictive, players call it EverCrack. Hudson, Wisconsin native Sean Woolley logged in, then logged out of life.
Sean was living at home when he bought EverQuest. After 3 months of playing, he was depressed, he hadn't shaved, he was up all night, and he wasn't going to work. He just stayed in the house. I'm starting to make my own conclusions. Like, oh my God, he's getting addicted to this game. He would try to talk to me, and he'd just stop. He couldn't express himself anymore. So Thanksgiving was coming. I came there to get him, and it was like 10 in the morning. He didn't answer his door, and I was worried. And then I broke in, and there he was sitting on his chair in front of the computer. He had a rifle, and I saw the computer game on there. I said, this has got something to do with that computer game. They haven't heard the last from me. I just made the decision that I would start telling what I knew, share my story to anybody who would listen, and try to get help for these people, because we didn't have any place to go for help.
So your son shot himself?
Yes.
How much had he been playing this game?
What happens is it's like any other drug. He started playing it when I was gone to work and at night. And so I really had no, I would have to put a movie camera in there, you know, to see how much he's actually playing. And even, that's what's happening today. People think their children don't play very much, and they have no idea how much they're playing.
And you blame the game?
Absolutely.
Tell me why.
Because before he started playing the game, he was like any other young adult. He had a future. He was looking toward, you know, what he was going to do with his life. And after he started playing the game, within 3 months, it affected him. He quit his job. He holed up in this apartment. He didn't go out. He actually was stealing the landlord's food. His personality started changing, and he became withdrawn and antisocial and depressed. And, you know, I was getting concerned, and this is only after like 6 months of playing. Mm-hmm. I mean, he was a person with a future. Sure. And after he got into the game, he no longer wanted a future or cared about the future. Mm-hmm. All he cared about was being on the game.
So, Fred, what do you think about this as you hear Brad's story and Liz's story about Sean?
Sounds like I could be headed that way.
Yeah.
Just keep playing and playing and playing.
And that happened with you, right?
Absolutely.
You stopped caring about the things that you used to care about and started caring about things inside the game.
You know, I've got so much in common with Fred in the sense that I had a career. I mean, I've got a university degree. I've also got a wife who loves me, and I've got to say that to Fred. I mean, that Fred has got a wonderful wife and a family who loves him, and I feel the same way about myself. But I became almost...
I've been talking to you at home about challenging you. One of the things you have to think about is, are you allowing this to go on in your home with your kids because it is an easy babysitter? I mean, think about it. They become so mesmerized by this computer screen that it's a perfect babysitter. It lets you go watch your TV show. It lets you go take a bath or whatever.
So what's happening is they are blending this with reality, and it becomes their reality. And they believe the characters are real. They believe they're the characters. And you talk to gamers and tell them that those aren't real characters in there, oh my gosh, they will attack you and say, they are two real characters. And I go like, no, they're not. They're just little pixels.
What's your avatar on there? Are you like a beast or a human or a...
Elemental shaman.
A what?
Elemental shaman.
You're an elemental shaman?
Yeah.
That's what I would have guessed. And this elemental shaman, your avatar is a female.
Yes, it is.
Why'd you pick a girl?
Because the male toons are really dumb looking. They really are.
Yeah, we wouldn't want to be dumb about this.
They're goofy looking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You want some goofy looking avatar.
No.
I mean, what would your virtual friends think of you virtually?
I wanted to say something about the virtual friends. They think that those are their real friends. And I'm like, they're not real friends. They're anonymous. Those people behind there can be anything they want.
I just met one of those people out here. I called him, I said, hey, I'm out here. And we went out.
Was he like really creepy?
No, normal person like us.
He didn't like, wasn't living with his mother or something?
No, he doesn't.
Okay, well, that's a good thing. Because
most of these relationships are just relationships of the worst kind because they're performance-based. You know, if I have a bad day in the game, everybody hates me. I was living to please the people behind those pixelated images.
Who you didn't know.
Whom I didn't know.
Yeah, and didn't know you.
Well, exactly.
And you could have been standing behind them in the line at the grocery store and you wouldn't have known it was one of them.
You know, right now to Fred, that those people seem so important, and after 8 months of not playing, it just seems so ridiculous that to me that was so important.
Well, my feelings on MMOs are, I don't want to play them. I won't play them because I have a lot of friends who play them quite a bit to the point where I can't talk to them sometimes.
What is it I'm about to do? I am about to delete all of my World of Warcraft characters, and I'm going to cancel my account, and I'm going to destroy my game discs. I've become addicted to World of Warcraft, and it's a very addictive game, and I've lost a lot of time from my life. That's why I feel that it's time to walk away from it. This is Bob Dylan, and he's my level 70 undead mage. Put a lot of time into him, and he's almost maxed out on enchanting and tailoring. So I'm gonna delete him. Ready? Oh, he's gone. I think that World of Warcraft is a tool of the New World Order, and other video games like it are also. Their intention is to distract you, zombify you, basically make it so that you are neutralized. And basically you're lost in this other world, the world of Azeroth, and in that world, you can be a champion, you can be a hero, and you can be popular or whatever, but in that's all artificial. Here's my next character, Cabo Wabo. He's a level 67 hunter. Level 67 hunter, not far from 70. Herbalism, alchemy. And delete him. Oh, he's gone. How'd you like that? 34, level 34 warrior. Gone. And that's it. All my characters are deleted. I'm going to remove my game from the computer. Remove it from the computer. Was uninstalled successfully. World of Warcraft was uninstalled successfully. When it comes down to it, you're just sitting there in front of a machine trying to get fake progress in your life that isn't really even happening. There's no progress happening there. in walking away from it, I've gained insight into the power of technology and how it can be used to neutralize us, to turn us into zombies. Take a look at your life and how it was before you started playing this game or other games like it, and then compare that with your life now. If you're heavily into these games, it's going to affect your life. It's going to have a negative impact on your life. It's going to take away from time that you could have used sleeping or exercising or eating healthy meals or being artistic or creative in many ways. I could have learned to play a musical instrument in all of the time that I spent playing World of Warcraft and games like it. And I could have mastered it by now. And what have I mastered? I've just mastered a bunch of dots on the screen, you know? I really haven't accomplished anything by playing these games. I've lost a lot. You might be socializing with the people in the game, you're just talking about the game, but you're not able to relate to people outside because the game becomes your life. And then what do you have to talk to other people about that don't play the game? Nothing. World of Warcraft is definitely evil. I'm on the cancel subscription page, and it asks, why are you quitting World of Warcraft? Put other first, and then the specific reason, I play too much, was one of their selections. So I put that. And then additional comments, World of Warcraft is evil. Yes, cancel it. You'll still be able to play until you're whatever. Yes, cancel it. Well, a little bit sad in some ways because I really enjoyed playing that game, but I feel happy now. I feel kind of freer, more free. Well, the flicker rate of the game puts you kind of in a theta state, which is like a hypnotic state, and it tends to make you very tired, just as an after effect, but also during the game, it puts you in a state where you're easily suggestible, and I've even read that it activates certain emotional centers in your brain. Seeing video footage of some kids who got really violent playing the game, that never happened to me, but punching walls, throwing stuff like that, you know.
Goodbye, World of Warcraft.
Level up in life.